Take a look at his picks. Mel Blount, Night Train Lane is on the back end.
Yeah, he does not have that tip drill ability active with that Night Train, though he chooses not to spend the cap on the out ability, so his defenders can drop the ball off of a tipped interception. Ocho Cinco and Randy Moss, they do have that playmaker ability, and the GOAT, Thomas Edward Brady at quarterback. That's his favorite Mutt item. That's my favorite player all time. I expect him to get work done, Scott.
Yeah, he is. Almost submitted himself as maybe the greatest quarterback of all time. And Trueboy is going to need a little magic. He's going to need a little magic. What's your scouting report here, RG, brought to you by Xbox?
Well, if you're Trueboy, you run the ball. We saw that in his first game. He's got Marcus Allen, and he spent the most out of anybody on his offensive line. And he really showed that playing to his advantage earlier today. The other thing he needs to do, like Gibbs mentioned earlier, is keep your cool. He did a good job of that in the first game. Continue to do that, True, and you're one of the best. With Los, it's get back your momentum. This is a guy that went 2-1 in the Madden Bowl and didn't advance out of his group after taking a long hiatus from Madden. But before he took that hiatus, Los was known as one of the best players in the world, and he has a chance to get all of that respect back right now by getting out of this group. He needs to keep his momentum going, get it back, and prove he's the best.
Well, Los will kick off to Trueboy. Los 1-0 here in Group E. Trueboy still looking for that first win after that wild overtime loss. And Hill will take it to the 25.
And we got a classic battle, Scott, of new school versus old school. I can't wait. Let's rock.
Yeah, Lowe's 28 years old, been around the Madden scene for a long time. And Trueboy, of course, number two in the world. And goes right back to Marcus Allen, who had one man to beat him, and Sean Taylor holds on.
Something I'm noticing with True's run game, Scott, though he's getting these 10-yard and 15-yard carries, they look like they're runs that could be crib shots. And when you don't convert the maximum potential on those run plays, it can be a little frustrating.
Talk about how much he spent on his offensive line. And this time, Marcus Allen. Well, Sean Taylor's two for two. Off,
and Allen is gliding all over the field. You see him right here, Scott. Look at the stick work. Turns upfield. But Trueboy said it, take off. He's trying to go to the cribbo, and after a while, 15 and 20-yard runs, they're cute and all, but you really want to break it to the crib, especially when you're getting that much room. Trueboy yet to be able to do that.
Sean Taylor saved two touchdowns. They're on the first two plays. On the third play of the drive, picks up four, second and six, already deep in plus territory.
Look at the stick work. Look how fast they're making adjustments. Look at Lowe's.
McNair. Quick throw, Marcus Allen, tired. Can't hang on. And you heard Trueboy said, oh, he tired.
Yeah, and he is, and you see that on your screen. He has a yellow fatigue level, which means he's pretty much mediocre tired. He needs a little bit of a breather after those two big runs he had before that play.
Scott Cole along with RG. Why don't they put my nickname in there?
Coltrane.
Nobody, I never see Coltrane up there, come on. Third and six.
Uh-oh.
The throw to Moss, and a great play in the secondary for Los.
I would love to see that replay. I think that was Loso the God clicking on himself and getting the user swat. That was a huge defensive play to force a field goal.
You know if they put Coltrane in there, they're going to spell it wrong. They're going to spell it wrong. It's like the jazz musician. There's a field goal. Big time bomb gives them a 3-0 lead. And now Los. Got to feel pretty good with that. I mean, you gave up some big plays, but you made a stop when it mattered.
Yeah, and that's what we talked about with True. You need to take advantage of those big runs, or else you end up with three instead of the touchdown.
Let's go to Zach with a game break.
Scott, over here, it's Silent Soldier against Misery, and Silent Soldier keeps it on the ground and goes all the way to take the 7-0 lead on his opening drive.
Wow. Silent Soldier looking tough as well.
Yeah, he's definitely silent, and he's a soldier because he fights all game long. You saw that in his last game against bad read by Loso. Throws in the triple coverage in the flat. How often do you see that happen, Scott? It's not often. Jeez.
I don't know what prescription those glasses are, but that was a rough throw. Almost got picked off looking for Dorsett. Second and 10.
Good play. Good hit, though.
Found a man open, but Johnson couldn't hold on after the big hit. Just like that, it's third and 10.
And that would have been one of those situations had Trueboy had a tip drill defender with the chemistry active. He would have held on to that interception. So that's the difference between having tip drill and not having the tip drill ability, Scott.
We saw it go big for Skimbo, but this is an overthrow. And there is Green, TJ Green, the former Clemson Tiger with the interception.
Surprise, surprise. You know a Clemson Tiger when you see one, huh, Scott? But that's a big play right there by True to get himself all the momentum that he needs. And you see he's playing with a lot of confidence right now, not being frustrated, positive attitude, and that's what we wanted to see from True.
And you have a 69 silver item to make a big play. Yeah, got to be feeling pretty good.
Yeah, it is a good feeling, isn't it?
That's the cool thing about salary cap. You never know when a silver or bronze guy is going to step up and be huge. Second and 9. He's got a field goal lead, and he's got the ball. McNair. Will hit Moss on the drag and drag. He will to the 39, just shy of the first down.
Good read by True. Stretched the field. Had a nice cross slant route underneath. Solid read.
So third and 1 now from the 39.
Lowe's with just goons all over the box. You see that?
Forcing him to put it in the air, and he will, and he finds nice. Randy Moss, who puts his back heels down at the 26. First down.
This is solid execution right now by True, and that O-line gets it done for him on the ground and through the air. Again, he spent the most money out of anyone in that O-line, and he's reaping the benefits, but a pass read right there by True.
Yeah, Mel Blount was right there on the coverage, second and 10.
Interesting thing too, Scott, on defense, Lowe spent the fourth most cap on his defensive line, so we got an interesting battle right there of an elite O-line and some elite D-line defenders going up against each other.
I think it's a factor of that and the amount of players he's bringing down to stop the run, forcing Trueboy to go to the air. Quick throw to Allen.
Well,
Allen,
watch out. Bro.
Have you met Night Train Lane?
And Night Train, one of them versatile defenders that can play coverage. He's big, but he'll clap you in a situation, and that's what you saw right there. Big play, Scott.
Night Train Lane had one of the best rookie seasons of any defensive back in NFL history. 11 interceptions. Third and 10. Dropping some knowledge on you, RG.
It doesn't surprise me anymore, Scott, with you.
Quick throw to Hill, the speedster. We'll use a little bit of strength to get to the 15. First and 10.
Wow, that's a big play right there by True. And remember, Scott, this is a kid. He's made every live event we've had thus far. He's trying to keep that trend going and make it into next week's Final 16. But in order to do that, he's going to have to fight out of this group, and which he's 0-1 right now. This is a big game against Lowe. So get Lowe to 1-1, get yourself back to 1-1, and then you're right back on your horse.
Big game, big drive, and I think you hit the nail on the head. Not only get the victory, but push Lowe to 1-1.
Yes.
If you remember, Lowe went 2-1 in the challenge and did not advance. Always a painful feeling.
And that sticks with you. Yeah. You know, you tell yourself, I'm not going to let that happen again. That's a learning experience right there for Lowe and something he was not happy about. It's a frustrating feeling.
First and goal, needs a stop. And there's Sean Taylor. He's everywhere. Gain of nothing. Second and goal.
And this is what's been happening to True. That elite offensive line's been getting these huge holes for him, Scott, that he's getting these chunks of yardage. But then he gets down to the goal line, and it gets a bit more stingy. They start bringing in that grizzly personnel, a little 4-4, a little 4-6. Gets harder to pound the rock in there.
Hand it off to Marcus Allen. We talked about that, winning those battles. This time he picks up 2. Big third down coming up.
Yeah, if you're close and you hold True to a field goal, you're in good position because it's still just a one possession ball game. Get yourself on offense, get a touchdown, all of a sudden you're all the way back.
Marcus Allen is breathing heavy on that one. Throws it up and just kind of threw it away there. And you got to think, going to have to put another field goal up after too much pressure in the back, but look at it again.
And that's some of that D-line that we talked about. Joey Bosa, Aaron Donald, he spent the fourth most cap on the defensive line, paying dividends for Lowe's right there on the goal line.
And for those that weren't with us last week, tell us why Joey Bosa, only a 97, is so big on those block sheds.
The thing that we like about Joey Bosa is that he has the 90 power move and the 90 finesse move rating. So that means no matter what type of pass rush move he tries, Scott, he's always giving himself a high chance to win. It makes him extremely effective in the pass rush. And he has a good block shed rating as well for the run.
So last play of the first quarter. And he'll find Brown along the edge. And that's how our first quarter will end, 6-0. And here in game number two of Group E, Trueboy's 0-1. And Los is 1-0. Trailing by six, though.
Pit. Oh, wow.
All good.
Tommy, ball game. Los using Brady. Trueboy rocking the Brady jersey. Strange coincidence right there. But Los is not looking Brady-ish right now with his reads. He has thrown into coverage several times so far.
Well, that's what you get with Tom Brady. They come back and throw an absolute dot to the 49-yard line.
And Brady to Moss. You remember what happened last time they were on the same team. They're breaking all sorts of records, Scott. Almost went undefeated if it wasn't for those measly Giants.
Ball pick it out!
No one wants to pick it up!
And it's picked up by Lonnie. Time.
I called that too.
Take Draw a look play. At the big hit, RG.
What? Boom! That's Trueboy with the user hit stick. Look, though, Scott, no one wants to pick up the ball. Who's going to make a play? And eventually someone hops on it for True, and he's got all kinds of momentum.
And that was the number 47, and it wasn't Mel Blount.
For second,
it was Eric Pinkins, a 61 overall bronze, making a big hit.
Dude, you're
causing the turnover.
You're a player guru, Scott. You see the number, you know the name, you know the school.
Second and 10. This is huge right here, RG. If you can go up 13 over Los, you're in the driver's seat.
Absolutely.
Dot.
Throw the edge and hit.
Way to go, boy.
Tyreek Hill pulls it in at the 23.
If you're Los, too, you're letting True get way too comfortable out here. He's screaming, let's go. He's got an extremely positive aura about himself right now. And if you're Los, you want to frustrate him. We've seen him. He starts losing his game. He starts getting himself out of his game when he gets frustrated. But he's the complete opposite right now. He is swagging up there on the main stage.
Tries to cut it back with Marcus Allen. Will pick up two. You can hear him talking to himself. Tell himself to wake up.
Yeah, and this is a good attitude from True, especially coming off a defeat. It's easy to get down on yourself, stay frustrated, talk about what went wrong the last game. No, he's blatantly put that behind him, Scott, and he's got a good aura right now, and it's working out for him thus far.
Thought we might see some QB power out of McNair. This time it loses a yard, so third and nine. Did not catch Los off guard.
You gotta wonder, is that Super Bowl patch right down there, rocking the Brady jersey, giving them, you know, a little bit of juice right there.
In your unbiased opinion, right? Third and nine. Play clock running down. McNair has time. All kinds of time. He'll throw it up.
That, yeah.
And that overthrew his tight end. That'll bring it fourth and nine. And
can't keep taking
it's a field goal fest. You can get your t-shirt at the merch table.
And you see, True, he says it to himself, Scott. He said, I can't keep taking three. He knows he needs, you hear him, you need to start scoring touchdowns. Nonetheless, though, still up two possessions, exactly where you want to be in a competitive Madden game. But he knows it's only a matter of time before Los most likely gets this offense going and puts some pressure on True.
That's a big time. Deep kickoff. Let's go to Zach with a game break.
Scott, you're looking live right now at a third and five with a minute 28 to go. Silent Soldier's got the ball. He's driving down into Misery's red zone, making some adjustments. 5 seconds on the play clock. Can he keep it going? Gets the drag underneath. We'll update you on any scoring play, Scott.
Wow, Silent Soldier looking good. Had an opportunity to maybe go up two scores in game number two.
That would be so interesting, Scott, if Silent Soldier did go up two scores, like you said, held on for the win against Misery, and then True pulled out the win against Los. We would have all four of these players at 1-1 going to game three of the group. That would be bananas.
That's something we haven't seen too often in this Madden 17 season. Second and 10.
Good play.
Nice throw up underneath. Trueboy paying homage, saying good throw to Los.
And that's that playmaker ability we talked about at the top going through his roster. It's an ability that costs Los upwards of 7 cap. It's a 5 cap ability, Scott, and it allows him to quickly adjust wide receivers' routes without the length. So he said, hey, go to the right there, and that's how he completed the pass. Playmaker.
So after the 7-yard gain on a good throw from Brady to Johnson, it's 2nd and 3.
Look at that controller cam right there. See how fast Drew's setting up adjustments? Look at Lowe's. He's stretching his fingers, Scott, as he takes it to the 2.
I'm not very good at math, but the 2-minute warning is coming your way. And
That's the
Reverend Los can just put his hands together.
Yeah, that's a veteran move, Scott. When you're a veteran and you know you got a long tournament all day, you're killing the clock during the 2-minute warning, crack the knuckles a little bit, stretch the fingers. I like that move by Los.
He goes to Tony Dorsett. And Dorsett, the former Cowboy, will get to the 28-yard line. Tom Landry would have been proud of that run.
This is a good drive together so far from Loso.
Under 90 seconds to go in the half. Back to Dorsett. And he'll get to the 26-yard line.
If you're low, Scott, the most important thing right here is that you get points on this drive. You cannot turn the ball over. You need to go into the second half with this being a one-possession ball game.
Looking to the corner. No one's there, so he'll throw it up underneath. Had a possession catch, though. And he'll only get to the 20-yard line, third and 2.
Still a good read, though.
And he'll pick up the first down. So now he's down to the 12-yard line. And Trueboy will use a timeout as Los is on the drive.
Yeah, True looking to save himself some time so he can get the ball back, try to maybe get himself 3. But right now, he needs to be concerned with stopping Los from getting 6.
Brady barking out the orders.
Good pocket. Wow.
High points it, but cannot hold on. That was Dallas Clark, the legend. Couldn't bring it in.
Clark had come down with that. That would have been crispy, Scott. The crispy step up with Brady into the pocket. Avoid the rush. High pass into Dallas Clark, but he can't execute.
It's a quick throw to the outside. Trueboy thought he had it covered, but able to get free. It's now another 3rd and 2, this time from the 4.
It happens sometimes. Those hard flats will get beat to the outside. Los recognized it, that he had a step, still slanged it. Good execution right there.
Yeah, that was a quick out. That wasn't the classic out route.
It's a big play right here, Scott. 3rd and 2. All types of goons in the box. Look at that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Is that the PA end around? I know he's old school, but I didn't know he's that old school. And he'll have to settle for 3. And
it's
a few years since that PA end around has been relevant.
That's
Scott?
Right, that's right. Still a good looking play, though. A lot of action on that, but doesn't come true. And so now it's a 6-point game. I mentioned before, Field Goal Fest 2017, live from Los Angeles, California.
Still some time, too, for True to get busy with the one timeout.
Let's go to Zach with a game break.
Scott, Misery only has 13 yards passing in this one. Silent Soldier, 10-0, but Misery does get the ball after the break. They're at half over here.
Silent Soldier looking good. Just was on the wrong end of that Los game. It came down to the final second, so that seemed not affect him. He seemed to be focused in there in game number 2. And there is the final timeout for Trueboy. 28 seconds to go, no timeouts.
If you're True, you got to be careful here after using that timeout, Scott. He had the timeout. Now he has none. Didn't even run a play yet. Really limits your play calling in this situation, not having that TO.
Seen a lot of timeouts out of Trueboy today.
Nothing wrong with it either, especially in the first half.
And Marcus Allen will pick up 2. And now Los has said, well, you know, I got 3 timeouts. I might as well burn one.
Everyone's being stingy.
Well, it's a tight game. We have yet to have anyone find pay dirt. 4 field goals in this one.
Yeah,
3 by Trueboy.
Got to stay stingy, especially when the skill gap's this even, Scott. These players are both obviously very high level.
There's Marcus Allen. He'll go out of bounds, and he'll actually lose 2 yards.
That's bad.
He's a fan of anime, probably, but not that animation.
And this isn't a good trend, though, we're seeing from True. He's starting to get into his complaints, and we said this is one of the keyest things that he cannot do if something doesn't go your way. It's all right to complain about it, but don't let it get in your head.
Cover two, press coverage on the outside. A little bit of motion, he'll empty it out, we'll see. Cover, going deep. Gaz a man! And good defense on the back end, that was Harrison Smith. Fourth down, RG.
Wow, that could have got picked off, but Los being smart on the third and long goes for the SWAT to force a fourth down situation. SWAT always safer than going for the interception, Scott. If you want to make sure that they don't complete the pass and you want to give yourself the best chance, you're always better off going for that SWAT instead of the interception.
Angled it toward the sideline, didn't quite get out, and now Los will have one play. 64 yards away.
Yeah.
From a touchdown.
And if you're True, you're in quarter street deep. That means there's three safeties back there. Good luck bombing that.
He does have Brady. And he will throw it up. There's no one to swerve.
Yeah, True in the three deep.
And that's how the half will end in the field goal fest. 9-3 here in the bottom of the fifth inning. I tell you what, I mean, Gibbs and I had this problem. Where we just had field goal fest. I hope I haven't transferred the bug over to you, my man.
I don't mind it. This is fun Madden football that we're watching here. Everybody's being extremely stingy. Nobody's laying down. And we got ourselves a hard-fought battle going on. Two players that have their tournament lives. They're both in a big situation where Los can go 2-0, give himself all types of momentum. True still fighting for his life down 0-1. This game's been fantastic.
Let's go to halftime with Dave and the crew.
Thank you, gentlemen. Rico, you heard our casters say it, Field Goal Fest 2017. Does this style of play, ground and pound, a lot of running the ball, does that benefit a guy like Trueboy, a young guy, or an experienced dude like Lowe's?
I think it still plays into Trueboy's hands right now. He's dictating the pace of the game. They're playing his game. He's running the ball. He needs to be able to capitalize more in that red zone. When you run the ball that way, you have to be able to put touchdowns up because obviously the opponent's going to pass and you can't come back with
it. I really like what Lowe's did going into the second. The 2 minute warning there. Total Madden guy move. Put the controller down. You know the clock's going to run all the way down. You're a veteran. You know the situation. You're not forcing anything. He had chew clock on. He was in control. I think for Trueboy, it is really good though because you do have the offensive line. So this is just one of those games that's going to be such a fine line because of how fast everything is moving that the second half is going to be so tight.
Absolutely. Our other game happening during this stream game, Zach, was Silent Soldier against Misery.
And more running the ball, Dave. That's all it really was for Silent Soldier. I mean, his backup halfback scores a touchdown. He doesn't care. He gets a big stop. He turns it into 3 more points after some nice. That's his first completion of the game. He's really only got one completion. Misery, no ability to get downfield in the passing game. He did punch one in, though, so it's 10-7. In the third quarter right now. Misery's trying to come back, but he's going to need to do more.
Misery's starting to make some adjustments. We'll see if he can finish that off in the second half. We don't want you guys to not forget that you don't have to miss out. You can catch up on all the highlights from the Madden Championship on youtube.com/EA Sports. And another reminder, we have a lot more Madden action still to come. Second half of Trueboy and Los. Trueboy's going to finish off Group E against Silent Soldier, and then the Madden Classic champion Spot Me will be playing in the afternoon. Right now, we've got Drea sidelines with Trueboy.
Thanks so much, Dave. Trueboy, you had to recenter yourself after that loss. How would you assess your first half performance against Los today?
I mean, I didn't play the best, but, you know, I'm staying in the game, so that's really all that matters. I know I got to, you know, have a little bit more energy, too. I'm not trying to, you know, be moping around and stuff because that's how I beat myself. So, you know, I'm good right now.
Well, let's talk a little bit about your demeanor. I've noticed how much you've matured. You're so much more composed now. Tell me about that.
Yeah, I know last tournament I was, you know, yelling and banging the chair and stuff, you know, throwing me off my game, but I'm good right now, so.
All right, well, best of luck in the second half.
Thank you.
All right, let's send it to Scott and RG.
All right, thank you so much, Drea. Well, you heard it from the man. Do you believe it?
I do. He's done, besides the one little outburst, he's done a fantastic job thus far, and that's when he's playing his best Madden football, and he's been playing good ball today. I mean, losing a game in overtime where you know, it was anyone's ball game. And now you're up against a world-class player in Los. True is back, and he looks like a man on a mission.
Well, the big deal to start the second half is going to be this first possession. And Los will have it at the 25-yard line, and he's trailing by six. And Los, nothing's going to face that guy. That guy is unfazed by anything. Needs a big drive here.
I mean, we asked Los what his personal motto was, and the quote that I have here from him is secure the bag. He's trying to get the money, Scott, and he's going to give himself a good chance to do that if he can get this win here on Trueboy and start off 2-0 in this group.
And it goes to Tim Brown there on the opening pass, and then Tony Dorsett gets bottled up, and here's a little bit of quick tempo. Haven't seen this yet out of Los.
Play, bro.
Just throws it to the outside and moves the chains, and that's a heads-up play by Lowe. Saw something he liked and then struck for the first down.
Yep, moving the ball well. You hear True, too. Good play, not getting frustrated, thinking about the adjustments he needs to make. It's a good sign.
Great play.
But eventually you need to stop saying good play, great play, and you need to punch him in the mouth. And enough of the good plays. I need to force you to make a bad one.
Time for him to make some good plays and great plays.
Exactly.
Ball at the 29. Los on the move. Throws it back against the grain, and that'll move it to the 18-yard line. Brady, 12 of 20.
He's slanging the rock. You see right here, this is classic vintage Los right there. Just finds people open, usually makes the correct read, and he is really starting to get in a rhythm right now. Scott, that hurry up might have been the move for him.
Yeah, keeping Trueboy in that defense, now allowing him to substitute or make any adjustments. Picked up six, and now he's got the ball at the 12. But he's been down here before, RG, and had to settle for a field goal last time.
Yep. Touchdown would be huge for him. You definitely don't want to settle for another one of those field goals. Will that be our fifth field goal of the game?
I don't know what the Madden record is. I don't think Donnie Moore's keeping up with that backstage.
It's a good reach.
And it's a touchdown. It's our first of the game. And Reverend Los preaching with a touchdown.
Did you just call him the Reverend?
I like it, the Rev.
I'm with it. This is a good play right here. You see the flats. They go with that receiver right there, right in the back of the end zone. Vintage, wide open. Good bench concept right there from Loso.
So a one-point lead. Tyreek Hill takes out of his own end zone. Let's go to Zach with a game break.
Cowboys, Silent Soldier, takes a two-score lead over the top, 17-7 in the fourth quarter.
Loving the emotion over there in game number two, Zach, and Silent Soldier looking good.
And let's remember, Soldier plays Trueboy next, and he has a bone to pick with Trueboy, who knocked them out of groups in the Madden Classic. They got a little rivalry going amongst themselves. That's going to be a fun game to watch next.
Eye formation. Trueboy going with a little tempo of his own. 2:42 to go in the third, and Marcus Allen reaches for the yard to gain, but he's going to be just shy, third and one.
True, really, just sticking to the ground, and this is what you want to do. This is his game plan, and he even said it when we asked him, what is the most fun part of Madden for you, True? He said, it's watching my schemes play out. That means he hits the lab, he finds what he wants to do, and he loves executing it. He's done a pretty good job thus far with Marcus Allen and that elite offensive line. Oh, no, he's got to be careful running here, though. There is goons all in this box.
He'll go to the air. Quick throw to Brown, and Brown holds on to it. McNair just 7 of 14 for 66 yards. So Los looking really strong on the defensive side of the ball.
But I do like that True's mixing it up, keeping Los honest, Scott. Changing his formations, not just staying an eye normal, going to some gun, getting some pass involved in there. It's a good mix-up of play calling we're seeing from True so far.
So first and 10. Goes to the pistol. We saw this before. He ran a halfback under, and he'll do it again. This time he's able to break the tackle, though, and picks up seven. Running the triple option in the Madden 17 championship.
Taking a page out G. Farrell's playbook right there.
Second and three.
It's a good passing situation.
McNair all day.
He's going
throws
for it.
It up.
He might
the
have
bomb.
That.
He caught and it. And Hill can't hold on.
That Tyreek Hill right here, trying to get a step, but look at the recovery speed of that 95 speed. Nice train lane, goes for the swat. Well played right there by Loso on defense.
Third and three, good quick play. Throw, gets down. That's Antonio Brown, yeah. Twerking to the 40.
He's been getting pretty doctric so far on this drive, huh, Scott? Couple of nice throws so far.
Really locked in.
Really. See,
a lot of balance. And his offense, he was run heavy in the first game. Finds it's tight end, he tight ropes down. Time for a game break with Zach.
Misery capitalizing on some sad defense from Silent Soldier, goes down, gets a touchdown, makes it 17-14 after the touchdown run.
So he got a little bit closer in game two, Misery coming back. So it's a one-point game here.
Why? That
and Antonio
animation.
Brown can't hold on as Harrison Smith was there on the coverage.
Tough drop right there for True, and that's the guy that's been getting busy for him so far on this drive is that Antonio Brown. Couldn't secure it right there, though. Got hit.
Just joining us. Welcome to the Madden 17 Championship. We're in Group E. Eight players have already punched their ticket. This is game two. Los is 1-0 in the groups. Trueboy. Number two in the world, he's 0-2, and he's got a man.
Oh,
and he carries him down to the 2-yard line.
Wow, that was a great play right there by True. Yeah, the trips on the left. Los doesn't have enough defenders over there to stop the flood. And look at Brown fight right here, Scott. Tackle battle, fall forward, 10-2. True's fighting.
Goal line formation. Will versus Will. And Marcus Allen.
Oh, man.
Boy, got to be careful when you're carrying the loaf of bread like that.
Touchdown, man.
Loses a yard.
A fumble would have been tragic right there by True. He's getting pushback from that offensive line.
Wow.
They're pushing those defenders back, Scott. But he just, for some reason, can't hit the hole he needs when he gets to this red zone.
And here we go. Second goal from the 3. This time, Marcus Allen will walk in. And the first touchdown of the game for Trueboy gives him a 5-point lead, and I'm done giving people the extra point.
Yeah, definitely not three no more. He's going for two to make it a touchdown ball game here.
Play action. High point pass and just sails it out, so it remains a 5-point game here to start the fourth quarter.
That O-line from True is doing work. He's got a 94 overall, Jason Peters. 95 overall, Mike Lupati. Eric Williams, 95 overall. Kevin Mawai, 98 overall. I mean, these are that's some serious beef up at the front, Scott.
It's been 192 cap here in salary cap mode. That's the number one ranked O-line going up against the number four ranked defensive line from Los, but now Los has the ball. Little playmaker, and that'll move the ball to the 32.
He's got great pocket right there, Scott. Watch how calm Los is when he snaps this ball with Brady. Just sits there, surveys the field, picks up the blitzes. Look at this.
And the pass downfield.
Oh,
and he can't hang through. On. Well, you got the old school man right there. I'm calling him the Reverend Los, 28 years old from Florida. So he's on the East Coast, and then you got the man from the West Coast, the 20-year-old number two player in the country representing the new school.
Oh.
And Johnson picks up the first down.
It's two good Madden regions right there, California and Florida. A lot of good Madden players come from both of those places. It's a battle, Scott.
High snap on the delay. And Tony Dorsett will get a gain of nothing. Dorsett does not look good in this one. 5 rushes for 8 yards.
The problem with that high snap is it mainly only happens on halfback draw plays. So it's a giveaway whenever you see that happen that you know to crash down and go play the draw. These players are smart enough to know that. So that high snap's going to make it hard for you to have success on those draws when it happens.
It's worth noting that that's the 84 Tony Dorsett legend. So it's not a rip-roaring beast card. It's a card that he used to save some cap.
And that's, oh, that's big. That's rough if you're low. So that's a really good point, though, Scott.
Oh, man.
Just because you have Tony Dorsett doesn't mean it's the God MC Tony Dorsett. There's a whole bunch of different versions of these players. And you can pick which one you want to go with. This is big, Scott. Biggest play of the game thus far.
Huge fourth and two. Los needs it. Quick throw.
Wow.
And finds Dallas Clark with a low pass to the outside. We know that is a lot of success, throwing it low on the outside to the tight ends.
Yeah, a low pass on these corner routes from the slot right here has been hell for people to stop.
And Dorsett gains a yard. Let's go over to Zach for a game break.
Scott, not only was Silent Soldier able to run the clock out, but he cashed in on point differential, going for it, and made it 24-14. It's now in the books.
A man from Crystal City, Texas, Silent Soldier, representing. Getting a nice win there.
Pick it! Oh.
And that was almost picked off as Moss couldn't hold on, and TJ Green almost had his second interception of the game.
I still can't believe we're a Trueboy win away from everyone being 1-1 in this group, Scott.
Well, he's still got some work to do. 2:05, 5 seconds before the 2-minute warning, and he's got a 3rd and 9 for Los. Trueboy needs a stop if everybody wants to go to 1-1 in Group B. Looking downfield. And a nice grab TJ at the 15, and that's
come on, man,
where the 2-minute warning will come into play. Trailing by 5, needs a touchdown, RG.
Loso looking to get that touchdown. I'm telling you, the way he's stepping up in this pocket and going through his progressions is immaculate right now, Scott.
There's another one over the middle. Jenkins with a big hit, but Ocho Cinco holds on down at the 7.
But it's going to get stingy here. He doesn't have those deep post routes to throw on the 7-yard line. True's going to be guarding stuff underneath. It's going to be interesting to see how Loso attacks him. Looks like he's coming back in a single back tight type formation.
2nd and 2 up on our center.
You got to watch the tight ends here, Scott. You got to watch these quick hits from the tight ends.
Need a little bit of that clock. He's going to stretch it out to Tony Dorsett, who runs into Malcolm Jenkins. That's that campus hero for the Eagles.
Not a bad play call by Loso. 2nd down, short. Give yourself a chance to run the ball. Maybe you pick up the 1st down.
High point.
Another thing he's doing, RG, is he's eating a little bit of that clock.
Yeah,
so if he
absolutely
can score a touchdown. And Dorsett will pick up the 1st down, so it's going to be 1st and goal on a huge play from the 5-yard line.
That was a huge 1st down for Lowe's, just because what you mentioned, Scott. He now gets to try to kill more of this clock and dig into Trueboy's touchdowns, who will make it harder for him to put together a prolific drive if Lowe's is to get in the end zone here.
2 timeouts remaining for Trueboy. Dorsett will fall to the 3-yard line.
Here's the problem for Loso. Is we have to say, we like to say, hold the door. Nobody is better at holding the door than Trueboy so far this year. He is extremely stingy in these short yardage situations, as you can see right there with the shoestring tackle, Scott.
Malcolm.
And now Lowe's has himself in a 3rd down situation on the goal line against the door holder himself, the Trueboy.
And you heard Trueboy say, good job, Malcolm. Malcolm Jenkins with a big tackle, 3rd and goal.
This is big.
Los won on a last second play against Silent Soldier. Can he do it against Trueboy? Goes back to Dorsett.
And he fights.
And Dorsett punches it in and gives Los the lead. Preach.
Oh my goodness, that's a big play for Loso. Loso to God. Most players will panic in that situation after the rim gets blown up a few times on the goal line. Scott, start airing it out. Loso sticks with his instincts and gives it to Dorsett. And he's going to go for 2 here to make it a 3-point ball game. This is big.
Heads this is up, big. Los. Goes 5 wide. Quick throw to the back of the end zone.
That's big.
And now the door is open. Look at the touchdown again, RG.
And as you like to say, Scott, Tony Dorsett punches it in right there. Punch him in the mouth, football, to fall over that goal line. And Trueboy just needs a field goal. The problem is there's 46 seconds, and he has no timeouts. He needs to get prolific right here.
Dare I say vintage? 46 seconds to go. 46 ticks. But no timeouts to go. McNair in the gun. He's got Marcus Allen to his right, and he'll empty out the backfield.
Yeah, if you're Losa, you got to watch Moss coming straight across on this post route.
McNair off his back foot. Cumberland, the tight end. Tight end number two will step out of bounds.
Yeah, you just don't want to give up the big play. I think a couple short passes underneath is okay. You just do not want him to get in field goal range on one shot. You have to make him work right now if you're Losa.
McNair has all day.
Good defense. And here the clock moving.
And big-time hit by Night Train Lane.
And those are like the unsung hero-type plays yeah. right there, Scott. If Loso doesn't click on to Night Train and clap Trueboy right there, he is so close to field goal range, potentially gets on his horse with Marcus Allen. That was a huge click-on hit stick by Loso right there.
Third and three. Needs a new set of downs. Here comes Bosa. Throws it off his back foot. Could not be answered downfield, and now the game comes to this. Fourth and three, fourth in the game.
This is big, this is it, Scott.
McNair. Throws it, and overthrow, and Los is feeling it.
Oh, man, I guess it's only a matter of time before Dre is going to get that interview that Lowe's warned her about.
Oh, man.
Because he is rocking right now. So we have Trueboy is going to be at 0-2, Loso at 2-0, and then Misery and Silent Soldier both at 1-1. Scroop's bananas.
Yeah, Trueboy number two in the world falls to 0-2 in Group E. And the old school guys taking it to the new school guys. I'm okay with that.
And I am. But no, we love Trueboy, but you got to take your hat off to Los. And he's showing that once you learn how to play high-level Madden, it is a skill that will stick with you for a long time. He was able to take a few years off, reapply himself to the game, and now he's back on top making a run at the Madden Championship with a $500,000 prize pool.
Yeah, when he heard about the cash, he's like, I'm coming back.
Yeah.
He's like, I think I can do that. Drea is down on the field.
Thanks so much, Scott. Los, congratulations. Old school prevailed. Those of us that love the beauty of football, that up-the-gut run, tell me about that.
Up-the-gut run for me?
Mm-hmm. On the goal line.
Oh, yeah.
Don't forget about that. That was big. The one that won the game for you.
I hate running the ball, so you said run. That threw me off. But, yeah, I had to get in there. Trueboy's tough. He plays great D, man. It was a hard fought battle right there.
Yeah, it was a beautiful run just up the center there. And overall, just tell me about what your message is. You told me before the game that you were going to give me something. You didn't give me anything then. Give me something now. The people want to know.
I mean, it's just crazy how these people are talking to me like I'm nobody. Like y'all really need to research who.
I know what you really want
to
say.
Y'all need to know who I am, man. I'm not some dude that just go to tournaments and just cheer for people like. That shit lurking amongst the whispers was ridiculous. I mean, that was the most insane thing I ever heard in my fucking life. And then the first tournament I went to, the dude spelled my name wrong, first of all. That's kind of, I mean,
Okay.
I corrected the dude. He spelled my name wrong again. I don't know who's doing that, but I mean, that's insane. There's no E in my name. I mean, it's simple to just spell my name right. That's not asking for too much. That's a simple thing. You need to, all these guys out here trying to win. I mean, just treat people, man. That's crazy.
Put some respect on your name. Spell it right.
Hey, man, I'm here, man. I bet they spelled that check right.
Oh, okay. Well, you're doing it big in a pink shirt. I know Scott was calling you Reverend Los. Tell me about this. Like, this is Easter Sunday up in here. Like, what are we rocking here?
I'm a grown man. This is how I dress.
Oh, all right. Well, let's send it back to you guys.
Thank you, Drea. Los coming in hot.